what happened to my football career is when I stopped playing football, I started coaching. When I started coaching, first I went to coaching course. After coaching course, I was picked by the Kafue textile team in Kafue, where I went to go and start coaching. After start coaching there, I was picked again by Zambian boys. That team of Zambian boys is where all this happened. Because they are the good players there, no, but didn't have a coach. So when I went there, luckily I found the players, they were listening to me and I was listening to their problems. But if you want to be a coach first, you have to listen to take care of the problem of the players. Sort out the problem of the players individually. Then you start going on them one by one. Then after that, you start working on each player, his mistake. After finishing that, I started this fitness training. This fitness training, the thing which players, they didn't know about fitness training. What they know is guys for a company, after they come back from the training, they were even coming, big drunk. And they took management. How can these people start coming with their drink? How are we going to be winning the games? So what I will do now, anybody who is come into this training, who comes to play pitch, smelling beer, I'll be chasing them out. So this was taught by the management, that shows me some Sunday. Just do whatever you want to do with the players. If we got no problem, what you want the team to win the championship. So anyway, since I was given those powers by the management, I started doing that. Luckily, the players picked up nicely. So after picking up the players, other people started winning games, 4-5, 5-0, 4-0, 5-0, 4-0. Until when we reached in the second round, we were on top of the table. After after finishing the league, we were on top of the and win the championship. After winning the championship, the players, what I did, I just told the management to buy them my suits. After buying them my suits, the players were happy, very happy, very happy. After buying them my suits, they started accommodating them, but didn't have accommodation. They give them my flats. Hey, imagine when you start doing this, it is not like here in Zambia where by prayer you start giving them alcohol, this is not there. They are all happy. Then after that, you were given a game in Mamba, Mazabuka. There is where what happened was we were involved in road accidents. I was not involved in road accidents. The bus which we used was not okay. As a result, we had the breakdown. Breakdown, we were given a pass, not a pass, a Toyota vehicle. Then that Toyota, when you come back from Mamba, that Toyota, the one who was involved with an accident, he wanted to overtake the station track, which was stationed in the the Kingston Road. And after that, the horse coach was coming here from Osaka here. He just switched on the light. What they did is to go in, and I was in student in front. Mm. I then taken to the hospital there. Then from the hospital there, we were discharged. After discharging from that hospital, I stayed there for 2 weeks. The primary permanent memory loss. That primary permanent memory loss, after discharging from the hospital, I was not training, I just put on weight, this diabetic food started again. I was not training, and as well as training, I stopped training. I was very fat. Then after that, I was too heavy. Then after taking me to the hospital, then the doctor there, they said, if you are not going to amputate your leg, you will die. That's how my leg was amputated. It was amputated because I was too fat and I stopped training. At least if I thought I was training, I should have been okay. Now, since there's nothing she can do, imagine there's no one supporting me. No one is supporting me. And then they disbanded the team and the company, they sold the company. I don't know who is running that company now. The one who was running that company, I don't know where it's going to. So luckily, I'm very lucky. At my own houses, which I built when I was playing in the international team. So my advice, in football, if you're a player, you have to think about your future. The issue I'm talking about is, you have to think about the way you're going to stay. You'll be staying when you stop football. It can happen. If I didn't have a house, I should have died now with depression. This man, the one who's coming to interview me, you know, from Egypt, he came to Zambia. Then my son, they're just looking at me. In fact, if at all I didn't have houses, because the goodness of good houses, which they are supporting me. So where I'm sitting here, it's my house. It's my house. Where I'm being interviewed, it's my house. Imagine if I didn't have a house. It is tough. So I'm just advising. This advice is anywhere in the world. It go through, not here in Zambia. Any player who is playing football, any footballer, you should think about your future. The future I'm thinking about is you should think about the way you're going to say. Because anything can happen to you. You see, anything like this can come. When it comes, it's hard to find you. You got that thing can support you. Imagine if you didn't have a house, this man can he come in? He can't. He can't come in. So my advice is think about the way you're going to stay. The way you're going to stay in the future. That's what I can tell you. I've got nothing to tell you. What I can say is God bless you. Thank you.